We are testing refrigerators and freezers, the kinds that are used throughout research facilities, hospitals, and frankly, every home in the United States. At research facilities, they house specimens sometimes that researchers have been working with for decades. And they keep them there and work with them year after year. And so it's vitally important that we maintain their integrity before and after an earthquake. In hospitals, they store laboratory contents and a variety of materials that are used regularly. And so again, we want them to be in operation after an earthquake. So they represent a component that is important to everybody that we want to protect in earthquakes. And that's really what the focus is. While we're testing refrigerators and freezers, the testing really applies to a wide range of non-structural components. Not just these, but anything that has a certain mass, a certain weight, certain dimensions, with certain anchorage conditions. And so we can translate this information into a wide variety of other types of equipment. So it's incredibly useful to have this baseline information and then to extrapolate and use it to tell us about other kinds of components. We're also going to use the information that we obtain to look at our building codes to see if what we have in terms of design requirements are appropriate for protecting non-structural components. So we'll be able to use the research results in this very meaningful way to extend well beyond this project.
For contents, we used sand and lead, and we attempted to load the refrigerators with 20 pounds per cubic foot, as is specified by code. The final motion run for each of the details was the 975-year spectrally matched motion, and this is a motion that used the full capacity of the table to shake the specimens. The spectrally matched motion was matched to the AC-156 design spectra, which is a design spectra commonly used for the testing of the functionality of non-structural components under seismic loading.
I think we gained greater confidence in our building code requirements. Everything designed in accordance with the code performed well. Positions were retained, none of the units toppled or slid. Thus, there was no safety hazard in a large earthquake. And that should be very reassuring to all of us. We also learned what happens in extreme and very rare events. We tested the freezers to a level of shaking that has a very low probability of occurrence because we wanted to see how they would fail in a very, very large earthquake. We can happily report that most of the freezers survived even extreme events without posing any safety concern. Along the way, we learned also that the effectiveness of the installations is related to a number of quality control or installation measures. For example, the thickness or the gauge of the refrigerators and freezers is important if we use screws to make connections to them. If we use adhesives, the surface preparation is essential to good performance. PIR has been a leader in experimental research in earthquake engineering for decades, and they also provide service to industry through the qualification testing they do of both structural and non-structural components. We needed a partner for our testing, and we were very fortunate that PIR came to us and offered support during the planning as well as the execution of our shake table tests. We could not have done it without PIR's generous support and guidance.